Did you know the Forest Hills School District is following other districts in introducing esports? And it's coming in handy for students at home because of COVID-19. WCPO 9 News reporter Paula Suro tells us why this is more than just playing video games.
Here at Anderson High School, during school hours, it's all about learning and picking up those books. But as soon as that school bell rings and it's after school hours, there's a different kind of learning taking place here.
Zendad.
It's competitive.
No, TSA, how could you?
Full of adrenaline.
I was gonna get him. He was so low.
And the outcome of this game is in the palm of your hand.
It's like any sport, except it's on a computer.
This is the Forest Hills esports team made up of 25 Turpin and Anderson High School students.
We know that video games sometimes are looked at as something that might be not purposeful or unpurposeful, so we wanted to make that purposeful.
But behind the screen, you're playing students from other Ohio schools, and the winners could even get scholarships.
People are getting really big scholarships just for playing video games.
Scholarships upwards of $8,000 a year.
It's a lot. It's showing times are evolving.
But to the students here, it's more than just the fun and the potential scholarships.
Yeah!
It's also the skills you get along the way.
I've gotten a lot better at dealing with things, and also, like, if we lose a match, you know, I've kind of gotten better at just being like, okay, this is all right, let's just reset it.
IT, students are building computers, we have students using Illustrator to do graphic design, and we have them getting into kind of the marketing and the commentary side of things through our streaming that we do online.
Their coach, Adam Samuel, says there are financial and physical barriers for a lot of students in the district to engage in other sports.
And they're competing also in Esports Ohio.
But this program, which is here completely free thanks to the Forest Hills Foundation, helps the students overcome those obstacles.
So esports has really been an opportunity that we can offer at a low cost, giving students possibly their first experience of doing team sports. So,
oh geez.
We know when we look at the research that extracurriculars lead to positive growth in the classroom. They lead to better relationships.
It's a nice thing, you know, to have another family, even if, you know, you don't meet them every day, you know, it's just somebody that you can still rely on.
Paula Suro, WCPO 9 News.
All these slices of life. According to Syracuse University, by 2021, esports will be the second most viewed professional sport.